My name is Derrick, and I have men boobs. I call them not so fun bags. It's been something I've been dealing with my entire life, middle school and up. Not a stranger to heat rash, soreness under the breast. It's just one of those things that can be depressing at times. It's just something in the daily struggle of a man with a man boobs.
I was brushing my teeth, and as I'm brushing my teeth, you can kind of see here. And as I looked up, I saw that, and it has to go.
I've had doctors let me know it's hereditary genes, and it's something that no matter how much exercise I do, they'll always be there, unless you make a decision to have surgery. And I really don't want to have surgery under anesthesia. In the back of my mind, I always have that fear of not waking up.
Hey, sweetheart. How was your run?
Great. Sometimes when my wife and I are intimate, and you're loving, you're touching, you're caressing, and she may fill me up like I'm filling her up. And as a guy, sometimes it's a little awkward.
I can't wait to cuddle up to your nice chiseled body. It's kind of been a security blanket for me. He's my cuddly teddy bear. You know,
I'd be a medium brown bear instead of a big brown bear.
Derrick doesn't come fully out of his shell because it always feels like something's holding him back. He always is self-conscious of where he stands, where he looks, what he wears. So I'm hoping when all this is said and done, Derrick and I will be able to walk down the beach, him shirtless, and just the confidence that he deserves. You know, this is a part of you, but if that makes you happy and I can't do this anymore, then I think, yeah, that's great.
Honestly, I'm 50 years old. We have 50 more years to spend, and I want those 50 to be without man boobs. See ya. You never know what happens being under anesthesia. I had a doctor one time tell me, see you on the other side. You know, what is the other side? Where am I going? Why am I going to see you on the other side? That was the last words I heard right before going under, and it freaked me out. So no more anesthesia for me. Box check for awake surgery.
Hi, I'm Dr. Gruber.
Hi.
It's nice to meet you. Tell me a bit about why you're here.
Been in the gym working out hard and just trying to tone up. No matter what I do, I still have the man boobs.
Gynecomastia is really common. It's the overgrowth of breast tissue in a man. I perform a lot of gynecomastia surgeries. It can be caused by an imbalance of hormones, by medications, but no matter the cause, it can be painful for men. It causes self-esteem issues, lack of masculinity, and it makes them feel embarrassed.
And with the awake surgery, what are you hoping for there?
I hate the fact of, you know, being put down, put under.
Yeah.
Terrifies me. A little tiny bit wants to see everything. But then you have the other side that's fearful of the blood, the sound, the smell, anything that goes on. So will I really be able to see everything?
Yes, 100%.
Right. You'll be awake. You'll be wide awake.
90% of what makes this either a pleasant experience or not is sort of in your head.
It's
mental. Patients who are really anxious and really tense, everything will bother them. I just want to do everything we can to make you relax.
Okay.
If we can't make you relax, you know, sometimes we just have to stop.
I'm a mix of being excited, nervous, anxious. I know my husband is very squeamish. He doesn't do well with smells, surgeries, sights. We'll see how that goes.
I'm going to do a little numbing, and you just feel like a little flu shot. That's all, okay?
Can I tap you to distract, okay?
I notice practitioners who put in fillers and Botox, they'll often put this little vibration device on the patient's face. And then also my dentist would shake my lip when he put the numbing medication in. I put those things together and started having my assistants tap the patients. Tapping really distracts your mind and your nerves from what's going on. Every single patient told me that it helped them tremendously. Everything okay?
Keep it coming. Keep it coming.
The next step is to take a cannula.
Gotcha.
It's not sharp. So I'm just passing this cannula through the fat tissues, which don't have a lot of feeling in them. and it's putting the numbing medicine in.
You should just feel some pushing.
Yeah, that's it.
Isn't that incredible? Because right now, you're not numb. I'm just pushing this metal pipe through you without any kind of numbing in there. Because this is putting the numbing in. Crazy, right?
Does it hurt?
It is. How long does it take this to?
To kick in? About a minute or two. Okay, so this is my electric toothbrush.
Okay.
When the fat vibrates out, the suction takes it out of your body. So it's sort of like if you saw wood and there's sawdust, the vacuum takes it away, all right? So it's not as scary as it sounds. All right, here we go.
Just a weird feeling, right?
It actually, there's no discomfort, just a lot of vibration.
So what was the most part you were nervous about?
Oh, this part here.
Well, you can't feel anything.
No.
You're doing so good, sweetie. Hey, girl. You know who that is.
Hey, babe, how you doing?
Doing great. How you doing, Mom?
Hey, how are you feeling?
I was nervous at first. Now I'm feeling a lot better.
Put your arm over your head for me.
Yo, that is wonderful, Derrick. I'm so happy for you. Now you pull off your shirt when you go to the beach.
This happens all the time. Patients call their friends, their family members. And that's one of the great things about being awake during surgery. And something I just love is to see that patients can ease both their anxiety as well as their family members.
You see what they're doing?
That's enough. I can't. I don't want to see no more.
All right. Love y'all. Love you, Mama. Bye, y'all.
And you get to stand up and see how everything looks. Make sure it's all even. Okay?
Okay.
Three, two, one.
No boobies! Yay!
Look at that.
Look how cool. Look at the nipple position. Yay!
I love it.
Feels like a dream right now.
Let me see a flex.
Sweetie, you look so cute. Oh.
Crazy.
Looks so good, right?
Yeah.
That looks good.
It looks so good. You can lay on down.
I'm just overwhelmed right now. I can't believe that they're finally
gone. I think we're going to need a piece of another one.
It's amazing.
Because of his fear of anesthesia, Derrick has been dealing with this for a really long time. And I'm just happy I can help him.
Good job, I love you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Can I give you a hug?
Of course.
Oh, man.
I'm sure he'll be hitting the beach with no shirt as soon as he gets the chance. Who knows, he may never wear a shirt again.
Bye, boobs. R.I.P.
Ever since the surgery, life has been amazing, you know, without the boobs. Every day I wake up, I'm just there staring in the mirror like, man, this really happened, they're gone. It builds the confidence up to a level that, you know, I didn't think was reachable.
Does it feel free?
Feels free, feels odd, you know, every now and then, you know, you look down and don't see the moves there, and it's just straight.
To walk on the beach with my wife with no shirt on is great. It's amazing. I want her to feel like, you know, she's with a man, not a man with moves.
I'm still a little lovey and cushy.
Since Derrick's surgery, he has a different swag about him. He has a different confidence about him. He's free. I love it.
Ready to go on the cruise. I'm ready to island hop. And if today's going to be my last, I want to go out having fun.
Shirtless.
And shirtless. I'm very thankful for Dr. Gruber. She was there talking to me the whole time on this side, not the other side. The weight process was definitely different. To cut a slab of meat off you and then they go, hey, touch this. It felt like a slab of salmon with a little bit of armpit hair on it. I mean, it was weird. And when I think back on it, I go, man, would I do that again? I mean, yeah, I would. The results, absolutely. And now I get to strut my stuff along my beautiful wife on the beach shirtless. What's better than that? That's awesome.